You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host, and we have episode number 250. And here to join us, who may possibly have done 50 episodes with me, not sure yet, is TD from Fuller Craft. TD, welcome. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You're a regular. We talk all the wonderful stuff that goes on at Fuller Craft.
Yes.
And June 11th, after most of the graduations are all over,
yeah.
Saturday, June 11th, 12 to 8,
yes.
There's all sorts of stuff going on
over there. There's all sorts of stuff going
on. So where do you want to start?
Well, I'll start saying that it's the South Shore Indie Music Festival, and it's a great thing to do with the family right after graduation. It's a wonderful graduation gift. We have about 18 bands that are coming to play live music. We have 6 art exhibitions that are there. We have 2 stages that are happening within the museum. So the folks will be performing from the courtyard stage and then also from the main stage out back. It's going to be a beautiful day of music, art, and nature. And our theme this year is Art Sustains Us. And it's all about sustainability and leaving a smaller footprint and, you know, talking about environmental issues and also just educating ourselves about these things. So with that theme, we have a sustainability series. It's called the Solar City Sustainability Film Series that's going on concurrently. So in the great room inside, we have these wonderful films that are playing all day. We'll have some panel discussions. We'll have like a mini performance inside the great room all about the environment and how we can take better care of it, including bikes versus cars. Mm-hmm. And I'll show you this card here. It's a documentary on, you know, this whole discussion about bikes versus cars and how the two can get along and emissions and, like, you know, where it goes around the world and talks to different people about this issue. Now, we have a panel discussion. So this happens at 12 o'clock. It's a 90-minute film, and then afterwards we have a panel discussion with folks from the Boston Cyclist Union, mm-hmm. Some local bicycle club advocates, and also it's being hosted by Velo Urbano, which is a local bicycle club.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, I saw the bikes and cars. And if you look at Brockton, they're now starting to do some bicycle lanes here, at least in the downtown area.
Ah, that's...
Over near the post office, near the police station, I noticed them.
Yeah.
In other communities, you drive Brookline specifically.
Yes.
Now it's coming to Brockton, and, you know, who knows, maybe there'll even be bike lanes in DW. Right.
That would be awesome,
So besides sustainability
yes.
and music, it kind of sounds like Woodstock and Brockton.
It
is. To a certain set. Not rock and roll, but... I'm looking at this list. Now, some of the
yes.
people are fan favorites and
yes.
people that have appeared before. We've covered some of this before. Now, we're going to tell you,
yes.
it's not all, even if we go there and cover it,
yes.
it's not all going to be on TV. So you got to go.
you got to go.
Tell us, here's the poster.
I'm really excited. Okay, so we have an awesome lineup, a real diverse lineup. Aldous Collins Band is going to be performing. They're one of the headliners. They're kind of like a Dave Matthews kind of band. They feel like that very feel-good jam band. Horns, you know, drums, everything. And Aldous Collins himself has a beautiful voice, okay. So we've got our headliners. Will Daly's going to be there. Wheat out of Taunton. And Wheat's done a lot of recording. They've got a number of their hits in romantic comedies. If you've watched romantic comedies over the past 20 years, you've probably heard a Wheat song.
Okay.
And then we have some of our old favorites, locals, like The Quins,
mm-hmm.
you know, out of Bridgewater. And we have Dark Matter mm-hmm. out of Brockton, Sadie Veda out of Brockton.
Sure.
We also have Shane Tyler, who's going to be performing. And he's a beautiful kizomba singer. So we've got Just a beautiful lineup. There's going to be some wonderful live music moments.
And your host is John Shea from Almost Famous at ATD.
He's hosting the Courtyard stage.
Okay.
And we also have Camila Benjamin Fuller and Christina Alexander, who are hosting the main stage, too.
Now, what's interesting, looking at the poster, besides all the sponsors down the bottom, to thank them, but the tickets are normally $25, but if you get them, by the 27th, they're 15.
They're 15.
So that's $10 less a ticket. So if you are talking about a graduation present or something like that, it's a really good deal. You just got to act.
You just got to act. It is a good deal to get all of that entertainment. There'll be food trucks there. There'll be craft activities.
Oh, I heard food trucks, so that means one of our staffers will probably be, I'll have to bring him back in instead of doing the concert, he'll be at the food truck. I know the new city planner is a big fan of food trucks, Robert May, who, and there are people downtown that want to do them. They're working on ordinances and all stuff. Yes. But I noticed on there also there's a hashtag. So the hashtag is Art Sustains Us.
Yes, hashtag Art Sustains Us. We have a lot online. Check out our Facebook page.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a Fuller Craft page, but we also made a page for the South Shore Indie Music Festival, and it's under that name. But if you look at Facebook, SSIMF1.
SSIMF1.
Yes.
Okay.
And that's also our Twitter handle, too. So
you got to be all over the place, and I notice all the symbols are down the bottom, and there's even symbols that I don't know what they are because I'm old. What can I tell you? But, it takes a lot to put this on, and it's grown from an idea, part day to a full day.
Yeah, yes, and really it started by just hearing a lot of local bands. There's a lot of local talent here. We were inspired to put together the festival last year. This time, and that was about 10 artists. Mm-hmm. This time we've expanded that circle, but we got a lot of the same local artists still, too. So we're kind of keeping that tradition, but just, spreading out a little bit throughout the South Shore and just bringing talent here so people find out about us and find about this wonderful event that's going on in Brockton. So it's very exciting.
Well, I think it's really crafty, shall I say, to bring music, other types of art, to the craft museum, okay? Music, documentaries, a little bit of everything, something for everybody.
Yeah, it all works in together. We also have our counter craft, indie, Voices of the Indie Craft movement. It's an exhibition, it's all about indie craft. Mm-hmm. So that's going on at the same time as the Indie Music Festival. So they all kind of feed into each other, We have 6 art exhibitions. You're going to have the visual, you're going to have the music, and you're going to be outdoors in the environment, and it's just a kind of a 3D event where you can enjoy all those things.
So the ticket price is also the admission price, correct?
Exactly, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And as you always remind me, I think we have a tiny tad minute.
Yep.
Minute. Okay. Thursday nights, you can get a sneak peek of everything at the Fuller because it's
free, 5 to 9. Yes.
And we'll talk about membership another time, but it pays to be a member because there's usually discounts on all of this.
Exactly,
stuff.
Exactly.
So give us your website and then we'll wrap.
It's www.fullercraft.org. Or you can call 508-588-6000.
Sounds good, TD. Well, we've got a lot to look forward to, and we'll sample it all, but you got to go. Saturday, June 11th, 12 to 8. Fuller Craft, the South Shore Indie Music Festival, and there's all sorts of documentary screenings, art exhibits, you name it, they have it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see you.
Good seeing you.
You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.